Previously on Black Gold. The competition between the rigs tighten up. At Big Dog, Justin battled through a gas leak.
Hey, I've seen it come out before.
And got to the bottom of the well from hell. All three rigs have drilled their first hole and struck oil. But at the brand new Viking, Wayne's crew barely survived moving to their second well.
Ow, man, my fingers. Whoa.
Now they're drilling fast and gunning for the top spot. At the Longhorn, driller Gerald's relentless style put them in the lead.
I run this motherfucker. Is that clear?
But it was too much for his crew.
In the low.
They all quit, and when Gerald couldn't get a new crew, he was cut loose.
Yellow.
Gerald, I've got to let you go.
Yeah, I think you should have been man enough to tell me to my face.
The race for black gold is wide open. With Gerald and his crew gone, it's a new day at the veteran Longhorn.
I'm gonna show y'all how to make a connection. Easy money.
And the new driller has a new perspective.
Gotta get up and show up for work. The whole main point is going showing up.
Gerald was an old-school roughneck, but the man in charge now is barely old enough to buy beer. He's responsible for a multi-million dollar rig and the lives of his young crew.
Hey, get your foot out of there, you dumbass!
Oh, I love being daylight, Jerry.
I mean, I'm young. A lot of older people look at me like, oh, that young dude don't know what he's doing. But there is a lot of stuff I do know.
Taking over the critical daylight shift means big pressure for Josh.
Ain't no ifs, buts about it. You're the daylight dealer. You better keep up with it. If not, they'll find another one.
He may be inexperienced, but Josh is running the only rig on schedule to drill all three holes in 50 days. Josh's style may be different from Gerald's, but he still has to deliver results. Young Josh likes to kid around, but he's not laughing when his mom shows up to bring him lunch.
Yeah, mom brought me lunch. She brought her baby boy some lunch.
So you make your mom come out here with a kid.
That's up, man. I wouldn't do that. You wanted to come in here.
You gotta see me.
Hey.
While Josh takes control of the Longhorn, the man he replaced heads back to the rig to clean out his locker.
Well, a driller's only as good as his worst hand. So if you don't have any hands, you're just not worth the shit as a driller. And that's kind of where we're at. It had nothing to do with my ability to drill. It strictly has to do with my ability to get my hands to come to work.
Gerald gets a look at his replacement in action.
You know, you always like to see what a rig's doing after you leave, see how it's going.
But he's not impressed by what he sees.
Wetting your brakes now with a water hose because he's got his brakes too hot because he doesn't know how to adjust his water. Oh, they brought what I would call a Band-Aid from another rig that, boy, hadn't been drilling long. His hands, ain't none of them got very much experience. It'd be like working with four peanuts. You know, I've got 32 years experience. I've forgotten more about this oil field than he knows.
This is nothing but disaster waiting on a place to happen.
I wouldn't be on a rig floor with him.
While the Longhorn has a new driller, the Big Dog's almost ready to find a new home. After 25 days, they finally hit total depth and struck oil on the well from hell.
Cap the well off, get out of here and go to the next well.
The drill pipe is out of the ground. But before they can move on, they have to line the hole with 2 miles of heat-treated steel pipe called casing.
Throw some casing.
Give a little pull.
Watch feet.
Casing keeps the hole from collapsing when the oil is pumped out of the ground. It's bigger and heavier than drill pipe. And getting 10,000 feet of casing into the hole is a dangerous, fast-paced operation to get it done without injury. A special team called casers will work with Justin's crew. Before any casing goes in, both crews get a safety briefing.
I want to be careful on rig 12 this morning. One of the old guys got hurt today.
Watch our pinch points. Make sure everybody goes home with all their fingers and toes.
You see them a lot, and you may have worked with a lot of them on a lot of different jobs, you know, but it's definitely different, you know. You gotta really keep your eye out on them.
Each 40-foot section of casing has to be sent up to the rig floor. Then it's stood up and secured by the stabber.
Here we go again.
Who has one of the most dangerous jobs in the oil field.
Nobody out here wants to lose a hand or a finger or any body part.
The stabber works from a spot halfway up the derrick. He controls the casing as it's sent down into the hole. Finally, Justin and the casers screw it into the ground. They'll have to add 260 more lengths of casing to complete this well.
Oh, it's gonna be a long day.
Even though we don't know each other, we gotta get a rhythm.
Hey!
Gotta kind of read each other and see how each other works.
There's no stopping until every piece is in the ground.
This is a pain in the ass.
As day turns to night, long hours and exhausting work take their toll on Justin's patience.
Come on! Let me call my sister real quick. She'll get it. You gotta watch out for things, man. You gotta keep a real good eye no matter what. I mean, always gotta keep an eye.
So Justin's basically up there by himself running that brake handle.
Hey, Drill!
Yeah, it can get frustrating at times for the stabber, get frustrating for the driller, yeah.
Come on!
Testosterone starts flowing a little bit. People start yelling at each other. But at the end of the day, we get in the hole as long as it goes in safely.
Damn, that's getting on my nerves. We finally got a rhythm, started getting, you know, getting a little faster and a little faster.
You can do it!
It took 8 hours, but the casing is in the ground on schedule and without injury.
It's been an interesting step. Most of the joints have been kind of short. I've been latching them all with my feet. 11,000 foot with your feet, that's a hell of a job right there.
The Big Dog crew is finally done with their well from hell. But tomorrow, they're looking at another brutal day.
We got a well done, but we got to move the rig, and I'm not looking forward to that. Not looking forward to it at all. I mean, got those 16-hour day coming up.
Over at Viking, the brand new rig is finally an advantage. Wayne's crew is fast drilling and have almost caught the Longhorn. They just passed 4,000 feet on their second hole.
That old Longhorn rig was tearing us a new ass there, but now everything's turned around 180 degrees. The rig's running real good. I think everybody else is going to have a hard time keeping up with us there.
Drilling is going well. But Wayne's crew is dealing with a new, potentially fatal threat.
This place is infested with rattlesnakes, man. It is way serious.
Any step you take could be your very last one, and I ain't bull about that. It's very serious.
Walking out across the yard, and I caught like the last 3 feet of the mother.
This is part of roughnecking right here. You always see snakes out here, but I ain't never seen them as bad as we're having them right now.
There are 10 types of snakes native to West Texas, and they're all drawn to the vibration, food, and water at a drilling rig.
Rattlesnake, man.
I like it. Smells real pretty right here, son.
You just got to get him right there behind the head like that. If you don't, if you get him back here somewhere,
like he'll right
run
here.
Around and get he's going to turn around and bite your ass. As far out as, in the country as we are right now, if he was to get one of us right now, you may not make it to the damn hospital. I really don't like to kill him, but I don't want to lose any hens over a damn rattlesnake.
With one less threat on the location, the Viking crew gets back to drilling.
We've done this before, man.
Longhorns in the lead and big dogs onto their second hole. So there's no time to lose in the race for black gold.
Beautiful.
Coming up, a hazardous rig move for big dog.
You don't put your hands where you wouldn't put your
and
very dangerous.
The Longhorns' new crew may not last long.
I want those inexperienced guys to be on other people's property and not on mine.
It's just before 6 a.m. in West Texas. Josh's inexperienced daylight crew is starting their shift on the Longhorn.
A bit breaker's too big.
Longhorn is leading the other rigs and on pace to drill all three wells in 50 days. But the crew change has the attention of oil man Mike LaMonica.
Roughnecks are here, sometimes they're here for a long time, sometimes they're here for a week and they're gone. Fitzgerald out there, that made me feel pretty good. He had a lot of experience.
Mike's company is spending $45,000 a day to keep Longhorn drilling. He'll check out his replacement crew in person.
Hey, what's going on? Mike LaMonica. Joe,
what's up?
Not a lot. I'm the EXL petroleum.
Oh, okay.
Pretty young driller. He looks about 24, 25. That's pretty young.
The young crew has Mike worried. He hopes the rig supervisor, or tool pusher, is on top of things.
How much experience your driller have?
He's got a year and a half, maybe 2 years.
So you're watching him pretty close then?
You gotta watch him all like a dog. I know how it is.
Yes, I do. His experience level here is really low. That's actually the norm right now in a boom. When we're in a boom time, you have very inexperienced people. It used to be you'd have to have several years and on as a roughneck before you get to make a driller. Those guys can lose fingers, lose toes, things can happen, and I don't even like to be up there on the floor. They're tripping. It's very dangerous.
Stand on this side and look up.
LaMonica doesn't like being on the rig floor, and he's even more unhappy the crew is burning through expensive drill bits.
This is your third trip in 3 days? Third trip in 3 days, not good. Cost us a lot of money. We're at $150,000 over budget on this hole. That's not good. I want those inexperienced guys to be on other people's property and not on mine. It's nothing wrong with him personally, but he has not seen enough things go wrong to watch out after his hands.
Tool pusher Benny knows what happens when roughnecks are in the wrong spot on a rig.
My derrick hand I had when I was drilling, we just buried him.
What happened?
Got caught up in the cat head. Messed him up bad. Took him 2 hours to cut him out.
I heard about that.
Yeah, he worked for me for a little over 6 years.
How old was he?
39.
Children?
Six.
Had six kids?
Yeah, that iron ain't got no pity on you. It don't take but a split second.
A rig is no place to learn on the job, but that's just what Josh has to do to keep Longhorn in the lead and earn LaMonica's confidence. It's moving day at Big Dog. They're off to a rough start.
Whoa, easy, killer.
The daylight shift is late. Derek got a call from Justin to come in early, and he's all not right. Happy about it.
Daylights didn't show up. Now that one of the hands is here, damn it, making me calling me at 7 in the morning when I'm in bed. It's kind of shit you deal with out here, man. Doesn't please me. You know what I mean?
As driller, Justin's in charge of moving his rig safely from here to the new site.
I just really just looking out for our equipment, make sure nothing gets broken, make sure nobody gets hurt, too. Also look out for each other, even the rig mover guys, you know.
What's that? Now you can take it up.
Rig move is the easiest day for a roughneck to get hurt.
You don't put your hands where you wouldn't put your... I'll put it that way, okay?
All three shifts work together on a rig move. They each have their own set of responsibilities.
Daylight driller and his crew does the floor. Our crews go down and do everything on the ground.
That means Derek doesn't get a moment to hide. The crew's broken down the Big Dog and it's ready to roll to its second well. The rig's handed over to an oil field moving company.
My main responsibility hauling this derrick, don't turn it over. My job is mainly backing up. Furthest I've ever had to back one is 100 miles. Backing up at 60 miles an hour, as long as it takes, as far as it takes, that's what I do.
Truck drivers, you gotta watch them truck drivers. Sometimes they're going balls to the walls because they want to get home. They may be, you know, still at the bar last night. You never can tell. You got to watch yourself with the truck drivers.
Big Dog's on its way to its second well and a new chance to get back in the race with Viking and Longhorn.
It's probably going to be another 16-hour day as far as rigging up and getting ready for tonight to spud in. Right now, we're trying to set the top piece of our substructure on the pony subs. Nothing happened till that's on. I mean, it's just a pain in the ass. It takes forever. Everybody wants to get their shit done and go home. Some homemade air conditioning here.
Setting up the 100-ton rig pushes the trucks to their limit. They closely monitor the stress on the cables. If a cable breaks, it could cut a man in half.
A lot of cables been used a lot of times, so they can break.
Rig move that good in there.
If that line were to part or if you didn't catch it, you know, we could kill somebody.
With the base finally secure, it's time to raise the derrick, 15 stories of iron and steel.
Rig's up right now, that feels good. Things are kind of going pretty smooth, actually. I feel like we could be ready to spud tonight.
With the rig moved on schedule and without injury, Justin's crew might finally get back in the race. Down the road at Viking.
Get to work, mother.
Wayne and his roughnecks are moving faster than ever. At 5,700 feet, they're closing the gap on Longhorn. Just 12 lengths of pipe behind. They've pulled double shifts 3 days in a row. And tonight, Junior wants to be anywhere but the Viking rig.
I'm ready to get the hell out of here.
Got a real pair of fast Freddy's right now. Maybe I'll get into a fight or two. If I don't get to get any yeah, like a fight. I'm a little tipsy right now, but that is okay.
Junior's earned this night out, but he has to work in the morning. Missing a day could cost him his job, a lesson Big Dog driller Tim learned the hard way.
Good hand's a good hand, but a good hand that ain't here ain't worth the f***. You know better than that.
Cheers.
Coming up.
You don't got this rigged up, right?
It could be a serious accident.
The new Longhorn Driller faces a critical test.
Don't get smashed down there.
And at Viking,
if I f*** up here and cost somebody their life,
the overworked crew is pushed too hard.
Ow, man.
Things are going smoothly at the Viking rig. Hard work and steady drilling have Wayne's team 4,000 feet from the pay zone.
There you go.
Like a lot of roughnecks, Junior likes to cut loose on a day off. After a big night out, a hot, loud rig is the last place he wants to be.
Yeah, I drank a little bit too much whiskey last night. I'm feeling a little slower than usual. Yeah, until then, it's just water, bathroom, and just trying to stay out of sight of people, so I kind of relax.
He could have slept it off at home, but Junior's grinding through his hangover for his crew.
Woo, boy, I'm never drinking again. Never.
Well, I did that a lot, too, when I was younger, back when I was first breaking out. My poor old drillers, I felt sorry for them.
Wayne doesn't give Junior a hard time. The iron does it for him.
I always try to give them the benefit of the doubt. Everybody has off days out here, and as long as they don't make it a habit where it gets happening too often, you know, then we probably have to take some disciplinary action there. The old boot in the ass trick.
Oh, Lord, I'm going to hell.
Viking is catching up to Longhorn. It's a struggle for Junior, but he still pulls his weight.
I'm never drinking whiskey again!
Yeah, that's what I said.
Never!
Over at the Longhorn.
Whoa! Whoa!
Drilling has stopped.
Whoa!
At this depth, they're at risk to drill into explosive natural gas. Josh's crew has to install their blowout preventer, or BOP, the critical safety equipment that protects them.
This is BOP right here. Your gas, keep it from flooding location, keep it from killing somebody. If you don't got this rigged up right, it could be a serious accident.
It's a big responsibility for the new driller. And tool pusher Chris doesn't know if he's up to the task.
Thank Josh and his boys. They don't catch on as quick.
Oh. I'm gonna put up this deck.
Even veterans are challenged when installing the complex valve system. Big Dog's last BOP fix cost Justin an entire day of drilling.
Get down and then give it all you got.
Damn it!
Get all them bolts ready. Stick it on there.
For Josh, it's a chance to prove himself to his boss.
Hardware and pull it over. Oh, that bitch ain't budging, is it?
But the young crew can't figure out how to bolt the BOP to the well. At $2,000 an hour to run a rig, it's an expensive education.
Yo, watch those feet. Don't get smashed down there.
Whoa! Whoa!
The BOP requires precision installation. There's no room for error when assembling the high-pressure valves and hydraulic cylinders that seal the well during a blowout.
Hey, did y'all put a ring in there?
Wow.
Wow, that's a heat dump, motherfucker. Coming up!
They're finally ready to install the BOP, but lifting 20 tons of steel puts Josh's crew at risk.
Slack off! It's at an angle!
I know!
With the well already $150,000 over budget, Josh has to find a solution fast.
I might as well use the truck. I ain't hurt. Pull it out. The hell, it's a big truck. That's what they're used for. It's what I bought it for. Gotta get my money out of it.
Josh got the BOP in place and got Longhorn back to drilling. That's earned the respect of his tool pusher for now.
I mean, he's done a bang-up job for us.
All right, but I will service rig next one. Let's get a little lighter.
The fix also helped Longhorn hold on to their slim lead over Viking.
I ain't trying to beat me.
I'm trying, yo. I'm trying to get this one done. That way we beat them.
Longhorn's hours of rig maintenance let Viking close the gap. At 6,700 feet, they're just 100 feet from the lead.
Come on! Get that hook on there!
After a long day of fast drilling, Wayne's crew is ready to hand the rig off to the next shift.
A lot of times when it gets close to relief time, you start looking down that road for the lights coming in.
We got one more hour left. It's been tough, but I made it. I'm supposed to go meet my baby doll.
Oh, yeah? Tonight? Hope so, man.
But roughnecks know their plans are always subject to change.
Yo, what's up? I just found out that the Morning Tower crew, all his hands just quit on him. So we may not be getting any relief tonight. So if y'all are looking for those lights coming down the road, don't get too carried away there.
Bull man. That is, man.
Work so many doubles, it does make it a more dangerous job. If I up there and hit the wrong lever, it could cost somebody their life or cost them their hand or finger.
Wayne's crew has worked 56 hours in the last 4 days. But with the Longhorn in their crosshairs, there's no slowing down. 5 weeks ago, the Viking crew was nothing but frustrated.
With those guys over there making hole, making connections, it kind of pisses us off. We work hard and we're the best roughnecks in the oil field. That makes us, that's what's going to get us ahead of them.
Tonight, they finally made good on Steve's boast. As they pound through their second well, Viking has taken the lead from Longhorn.
They had a big head start on us. Now we're ahead of them guys. So we're going to start tearing all these rigs around here a new.
With Viking on top for the first time, Steve can finally enjoy the view. Coming up, sparks fly on the Longhorn.
Get up, Josh, that cold bus is coming.
As Josh gets a wake-up call. And later at Big Dog.
All right. You see me on this damn handle right now? Why are you throwing your chain?
Justin's fed up with Derek's mistakes. It's before dawn in West Texas. Driller Josh rounds up his crew to head out to the Longhorn.
J-Rod.
But just hours before, Josh and his crew were belly up to the bar.
Wow, pretty up.
They tried to rest up on the drive-in. With so many hazards on a rig, a tired roughneck is a dangerous one.
Well, I think I got teeth up last night. I woke up this morning feeling it now.
Despite their aching heads, the drilling begins. But Josh isn't on the rig floor for long.
Pretty good driller when he ain't sleeping. Now that tool pusher comes in here and catch him sleeping during daylight, so his body get ran off. He can't be doing all that. So he gets ran off, we all get ran off, so he needs to wake up.
Josh is lucky to have a loyal crew.
Get up, Josh, that tool pusher's coming.
Josh's crew saved him for now. But he has to get Longhorn moving. Because Wayne and the Viking crew are pulling away.
Beautiful.
After working a double, the Viking has taken over the lead and is near the bottom of their second well.
Everything's running real smooth today. Just the way we like it.
They're just 2,000 feet from the pay zone. With drilling going so well, Jr. has a chance to clean up the rig.
We want to work on a nice, sexy rig, man. We don't want to work on no junky-ass motherfucker.
Unlike the other shifts, Steve and Jr. take pride in the new rig looking good. But Jr. is struggling with equipment problems.
$1 billion operation over here, and all we got is these little ass paintbrushes, man. You'd think they have bigger ones, but I guess we don't. I wish Steven would hurry up with that paint gun over there so I could use it. Has anybody been cleaning this up, Kenny, besides
us? Other than us, no.
Nuh-uh, for real?
For real.
$250 paint gun, and they don't even keep it clean. These hands nowadays, they just don't care, man. Me and Steven are like the old days, ain't we?
Yeah, so, we got broke out by the
we got broke
hard out nose.
The hard people.
Like Wayne.
Being an older and experienced driller like myself, there, I think these hands, they feel a lot more comfortable working with me than, than say someone that don't have that much experience. To me, this is very important because this is what I do for a living. The younger guys, maybe they don't take the job as serious as I do. I mean, dude, you could never come up here on the rig floor and catch me sleeping on the job.
It's a hell of a hangover. That's what it is.
Driller ain't supposed to be sleeping. That's what drillers get away with doing because they're a driller. This guy keeps me out all day, and he comes to work and goes to sleep. I'm supposed to be on watch out, but I ain't watching out all day long. I got stuff I gotta get done.
Josh has already lost the Longhorn its lead. At this rate, the rig will be lucky if they make it to oil at all. Coming up, Josh's crew is under the gun at Longhorn. And an accident on the Viking shakes the crew.
It's a fun job, man, but it's a thing.
The veteran Longhorn has lost the lead.
Hurry it up, hurry it up.
They'll need to pick it up if they want to beat Viking to oil. But a problem shuts the rig down for the second time in as many days.
Yeah, this is just something that jumps and bites you in the ass while you're drilling.
Once again, they've stopped drilling to work on their blowout preventer.
Hey, did y'all put a ring in there?
The inexperienced crew just installed the BOP, but it's already leaking water.
Hold on.
If they hit a pocket of gas, a blowout could kill Josh and all his roughnecks. But the crew isn't thinking about the dangerous situation.
Come on, bitch. These right here are on their tight, though, so. It sucks. When they're all nasty and dirty like this, it takes longer because all these threads right here are all full of dirt. All together, there's a good at least 40 volts.
Josh is ready to work. But the roughnecks who covered for him all day are ready for a break.
I really don't want to do this, though. You want to smoke real quick and then do it? Hey, did you just bend that, Josh? Huh?
It's a slow, grueling task, and every hour down is $2,000 wasted.
A little harder.
The company we're working for, that Adobe's working for, EXL, it's gonna cost them a lot of money at the moment.
We still got a good 30-something volts to take off. We've only got a couple of them taken off.
All these delays right here, it's easy money for us. I got about 4 more hours. I don't care less. I'm going home.
Josh may not care, but his boss knows they have to get the Longhorn back to drilling.
You're watching him pretty close, man. You gotta watch him all like a dog.
With With their rig at a standstill and money pouring down the drain, maybe Josh is bitten off more than he can chew as the Longhorns' new driller. While the Longhorn struggles to get moving, the big dog rig has settled into their new home.
Beautiful day in the neighborhood. Oh, in the neighborhood.
First day on the new home. I'm hoping this will be a little bit better of a well.
It might be a new well, but they have the same old problems with their worm, Derek, and his slacker attitude.
Hung over. Usual.
Get him on there, Derek.
Put your into it.
This guy down here, Derek, he's still a worm, you know. You gotta argue with him and tell him what to do, but, I mean, he'll do it. He's a good dude.
Hey, you gotta put out on that scrub brush, baby.
Hey,
you gotta put out.
Put out.
When I was in high school, this is always what I dreamt about.
Jazz down there and get that pipe on the rack, though. Stinking worm.
A good lead tong hand would already have that pipe ready to go.
See, he's mad at me now. So he's being over-aggressive. Now he's going to have to straighten that pipe out a little bit.
Justin wants to turn the worm into a good roughneck, but Derek still struggles with the basics.
All right. You see me on this damn handle right now? Why are you throwing your chain? I just told you to pay attention. If you're going to throw chain, watch me, man. All right? $1 million operation, and you're shutting us down.
That's a stinking worm for you. He wants to play with the chain.
He's trying to learn how to throw chain, but he doesn't pay attention. It causes more time. It takes us a little bit longer to make our connections. We got to stop.
Yeah, I threw the chain too early. Hey, you know. Now with these drillers, man, sometimes it's no ups, you know.
Probably the worst connection in the history of connections.
While the big dogs just started their second well, the Viking is finishing theirs up.
There's your chance, come on.
Wayne and his crew are ahead of the other rigs. More than 9,000 feet deep, they're closing in on the pay zone of their second well. The Viking Roughnecks are pushing themselves to keep their momentum going.
Come on now.
My glove got sucked off by the spinning chain and then it whacked me in the elbow. It's after me tonight.
The cuff of his glove was so loose that he got hung in the chain. A lot of guys got hurt like that. I've seen a bunch of old men with fingers missing and stuff, and that's exactly how it happens right there.
Yeah, that happened to me about a week ago. You just gotta be real careful. Scary feeling, you feel like your arm's gonna get pulled off.
Makes me think I could have lost my hand, but we try not to think about it, just keep moving, man. Don't let it stop you.
A $4 pair of gloves almost cost Steve his hand.
The cuff on the gloves was, it was stretched out and tore already. I seen it, but actually I should have brought that to his attention earlier. That was an oversight on my part. You need some new gloves? Nobody get hurt on my ship there. That's my number one priority right there, safety. I'd rather give up a pair of gloves and have him safe than have an accident over a wore out pair of gloves because it just ain't worth it, you know.
Steve got lucky this time and managed to escape without injury. Now, Wayne and his crew are back in action and ready to drill their last 1,000 feet to get to black gold. Coming up.
That's the name of the game, buddy.
Wayne and the Viking crew eat up the competition, but did they drill a dry hole?
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah. This time, rock and roll, man.
Wayne's headed to work on the Viking rig.
All
And he'll enjoy the ride today. His crew should be hitting bottom on their second well.
We're fixing to pass by the old Longhorn up here. We are tearing these guys a new ass, man. They just can't hang with the big boys the way I see it. We took over the number one spot. Today we ought to be finishing up our second hole. Leave these boys in our dust. They'll just see the dust from our rig move. There's all they're gonna see.
The Viking has overcome dangers of all kinds.
This place is infested with rattlesnakes.
To finish their second well.
TD, hit our spot.
And beat the competition.
Looks like the Longhorn's kind of lagging behind over there. Too bad for them, man. To finish this up, we're going to move right down the road. Go get us another one, and I guarantee the time we get through with that well down there, they're going to be even further behind. That's the name of the game, buddy.
They'll have to keep up the fast pace. Wayne's crew is now the only team on schedule to finish all three wells in 50 days.
Just finishing the well right here. I earned it.
The Viking crew is feeling satisfied. But for Mike LaMonica, nothing is certain. Mike took a big risk drilling in unproven territory. So far, the gamble's paid off.
Got a heck of a well.
Pretty pot. This ought to be a pretty dang good little well.
But his luck could run out here.
We're looking at the porosity, which is the holes in the rock, which is really, really good. It's calculating the water saturation at 13%. Subtract that from 100%, you get 87% oil.
Awesome.
The fact that that's not water is really, really, really good. I could have 150,000 barrels of recoverable oil out of that 20-foot section.
Yeah.
So that's really good. Everything's indicating there's a lot of bulk oil.
It looks like Viking drilled EXL's best well yet.
That is very, very, very super awesome right there.
LaMonica thinks it will produce more than 300 barrels a day. At current prices, that could be worth more than $200 million in black gold. On the next episode of Black Gold.
What are you doing, dude?
At Big Dog, Justin loses his patience for Derek.
How many times have we done this?
When drilling stops for Wayne and the Viking crew.
That ain't good, man.
Mike LaMonica fears the worst.
So now we're screwed.
And at Longhorn, poison gas threatens lives.
It will kill your ass, I guarantee it.